Last week, President Yoweri Museveni appointed new members of the Electoral Commission and renewed tenure of the chairperson, Justice Simon Byabakama, the vice-chairperson, Hajjat Aisha Lubega, and Commissioner Stephen Tashobia. He also appointed four new commissioners, including Dr. Sally Simba Kayunga, Anthony Okello, Pamela Etonio Kudi, and Robert Kasule Sebunya. However, as the Appointments Committee of Parliament sought to vet the appointed nominees, it was learnt that the president had appointed another composition, dropping the former Nasarawa Municipality Legislator Robert Kasule Sebunya and Pamela Etonu Okudi, and replaced them with James Peter Emorot and Caroline Bainamario.
So for us, we can participate, maybe, I'm not very sure, and we may not. But what matters most among all those positions we contest in politics is the position of president, because the president determines everything, including lives of Ugandans, including peace. So if for you, I know you are just looking at the parliamentary position, because you are going to tell me that now it is the same people who announced you when you stood in 2021. Yeah, they did. But I'm not looking at the position of parliament. I'm looking at the position of a president. Because when you're a president, you determine almost all aspects of a country.
Competently, Justice Byabakama was able to not only fairly, but very well explain some of those concerns come back to us as parliament. For example, if you are asking about the voter education, but here at parliament, and he said it, we are giving him 300 million per year. And we only, by the way, even then that one comes into quarters. So how do you traverse this country on voter education, apart from maybe appearances on TVs and the radio?
This time, the committee meeting sat in the speaker's boardroom instead of the usual committee rooms. The last-minute changes got members by surprise, as some showed up with faces covered by face masks.
It is true that some of the nominees, as they came putting on masks. But once they got in, at least the Right Honorable Speaker, who was the chair, was very categorical in informing them to remove the mask.
Peter Ekot, the Tochi County MP, revealed that the committee pressed Byabakama for his shortcomings of the 2021 general elections.
There were questions put, but at least what he did say, of course he mentioned a number of challenges. One of them was managing an election during a scientific election, which came during COVID, which posed quite a number of challenges, one of which there was not enough time to do voter education. Apart from the challenge of resources, apart from funds, which he actually did say, the commission actually received only 300 million.
However, some legislators, led by the leader of opposition, Joel Senyonyi, have invited for reforms in the process of appointing the Electoral Commission members as a way to guarantee credible elections.
A day must come when an electoral commission of a country, number one, is not appointed as it is now by a candidate, by a player, that you are going to participate in a game of football and you're the one selecting the referee. How do you expect that referee not to tilt the game to your side?
It's regrettable that you're working in systems that we oppose and that we are opposed to. We think a lot of things have to change on these appointments, not only with the Electoral Commission, but several appointments. We think a lot of things must change.
To the surprise of many, after vetting, the nominees sneaked out of Parliament through the back door in a move to avoid scrutiny of journalists who kept waiting at the Parliament lobby.
Well, I'm not aware, because I remain inside and they came in one by one, and each time we finish with each commissioner, they leave the room. So how they got out of the room, out of the premises, I'm not aware.
Report compiled by Fred Kajibi for the news at Parliament.